Welcome to Weekend Project. I'm Laura Lynn of the Mom and Pop Quilt Shop, and we're very happy to see you here today. Today, we're working with panels number 5, and it doesn't matter what panel you're working with this idea that I come up with, and it was using the Dresden ruler, but we're not gonna make Dresdens or flowers or anything else of it. We're gonna make like a border to border out the panel, which is gonna add like 18 inches this way and 18 inches this way if you surround it all the way around. So what I was doing, or what I was thinking about when I was looking at the panels that I have, because I mean, we all know I have a lot, is I did down the sides and long sides first and then across the top just to, I guess, kind of even it out, because of course it is longer than it is wide. So I thought if I did down the sides and then across the top, and of course when you're using the Dresden ruler, you're going to actually, this isn't a straight edge here, so you're going to actually have to cut one of your Dresden blades pretty much in half on either side. So make it sure it's, you know, I wouldn't say it was your favorite fabric or the one you wanted to have featured in the quilt, but you know, mix and match it and have some fun. So I am working on the last little strip that I have for the quilt that I'm working on, the panel piece, but I'm going to show you how I used just the Dresden ruler, how to just to cut. It's very simple and easy. This was given to me as a gift from Lois, and I gave one away to one of our fans during one of our 12-hour live streams, which tomorrow we're having a 12-hour live stream, 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern. Check it out. We're going to have some giveaways and have some fun. We're going to make homemade pizza. I'll be making the dough earlier in the morning. That way it has plenty of time to rise and hang out. And then the boys are going to be making pizza. So I'm very, very excited by this. And we're doing Pops Block of the Month. And we're going to work on a quilt for one of you guys. Gets to win. So you place the ruler on your fabric, whichever way you wish to use it. Sometimes if you're thinking about way things lay out, you may want to do it directional, your fabric directional, depending on how you're, if you have directional fabric. It's best kind of to use neutral ones, though I do have some directional ones in the project that I was working on. So I found it easier to just lay the ruler out. You can either put it this way or that way, it doesn't really matter, but just making sure you're giving yourself enough room all the way around it. Now this is where one of those little twirly whirly birds boards would be handy. I know I have one, but yeah, didn't go looking for it. So come all the way up with your ruler, and this is where you can take your fabric away. I'm cutting 4 at a time, okay, and then I'm just going to turn it without moving anything else. I'm turning the project to ease me in the cutting. I'm not trying to go over this or under that or anything else. I could risk losing my precious little digits. So no thank you. I like them. They're very much attached. So I'm just moving it around in a gentle manner. And I liked, as soon as I took the little paper plate or paper off the backing, it glowed. It seemed to like glow on the fabric. It was like, I've never had a Dresden template like that. I've only had my big, big, big white one. Okay. So thanks again, Lois. This has been fun. Trying to think of what else to do with the Dresden ruler besides make Dresdens, right? So, all right. So, and there we go. And then you'll have 4 exactly like that if your wrong sides were together and you stacked it double. And then you just literally sew them from wide end to narrow end. And you could insert another color in between, and you could have this lovely, beautiful, different, unique sort of thing happening, right? So, like, and there you go. And that's pretty much what we started right here. So I do have another project that I would like to do with it. It's actually here. Let me move the one I'm working on, because it is a little Christmas panel here. Is this one here. And I didn't think anybody was ever going to believe me that I got this one panel piece, and it still has a tag on it, from the Missions Thrift Store, $2. $2. Maybe Munch can zoom in on there. I only paid $2 for this panel. And there's also matching ocean fabric that goes with this. So I just need to find it. But other than that, I've busted some of my blues and some of my greens and some of my tans to be able to do the same thing around this project right here. And then hopefully I am going to sell it. So that would be lovely. Isn't it a lovely big panel for $2. So check your little thrift stores if they're open. You know, I know we've had some serious things going on all over the world here. Everybody's suffering the same problem. But if your thrift stores are open or your secondhand places, always check those sorts of spots for fabric deals. You just never know. And I think I got about 4 meters of fabric that matches that for also $2. So it was like pretty much a whole quilt top for $4. So steal deal. All right. So I don't need any of these blues for this project here. We're going to continue working on the other border piece, which I'll show you here. We're just doing to do the top. This is a 12 days of Christmas panel. So I'm doing Christmas in the summer here. I'm not going to say July because it's not July, but it is the end of June. And isn't that nice? And you don't have to worry about matching it up, whether it comes to top border or the bottom border, because they're all half pieces as you trim them. So really it takes all the stress out of it. You just have to make sure you're getting the proper measurement up, whether, you know, this was a 43 by 23. So now it's going to be a 43 by like 60 or something like that. So that is a great way to bulk out a panel without doing too much work. You're just building yourself a nice 9.5 inch border to go all the way around. Mixing your fabrics, because this is all Christmas, so I took all the Christmas fabrics that I can find, even some with the new box that Jo Marie dropped off, and there was only a tiny little triangle of this fabric right here, so I got one. I got one out of it, but it was so cute with the Santa Clauses, right? Old Saint Nick. All right, so let's just scoot this here so you can see it. And we're going to continue putting together the top piece because we need the top piece here. So I need it to be 42.5 inches, 42, 43, 42 and a half, 43 inches. I think it was 43. And then we just attach it to it. But we don't want it too loose. We don't want it too tight. We want it to fit nicely where it's supposed to be. Because if we decide to put a nice little strip of border around here with, you know, complementary fabric color to this blue here or this kind of burgundy, you know, rusty cranberry color right there, we want it to be able to still pop and be beautiful. I also thought that you could, if it was a busy panel and it didn't have this little border here, you could add a border first and then add, like make it like a really nice contrasting color, like a white or something like that, and then have your pop of your scrappies. Or if you're just doing a flip and flop two colors, it would still look beautiful no matter what. You'd have, you know, some would look like trees. I thought with the aquatic one, the panel there, that they would almost look like fishes. So that's actually was the original day, and I'm like, okay, well, let's grab one of the Christmas panels because you got a lot of those, Laura Lynn. let's work on one of those. So yeah, hopefully the idea serves you well and you run crazy with it. So now to piece these pieces together, because they're clearly not straight, well, they are straight edges, but they're not lining up as, you know, a 45 and a 90. You have to put them on the angle. So when it comes to the big side and the little side or the bottom sides, you just want to make sure they're lined up almost tip to tip for corner to corner. You don't want to go too far and you don't want to go too low, or your row is going to be off in the smoothness, right? And so of course you're still going to be able to still have to trim, but you know, that's okay. You can trim just a smidgy. It doesn't have to be too much. Even it out. All right, so just a neutral colored thread here and a 1/4 inch seam allowance. I'm going to go all the way down on the one side, lining up. You don't have to pin. This is one of those nice ones that I felt you didn't have to pin. Now, since I was a little over, let's go back and check that one. Oh, yeah, it's a little shy. Let's go back. Yeah. Because I moved it as I was talking. So let's go back here. There we go. All right. I can see it on the cream side. We don't want any holes or gaps, so let's just fix them while we can. And I've just been taking from my pile of mixes that go all the way around this. There's replicas of this cream colored here, but other than that, I tried to keep one color or one Dresden piece per row just to, you know, give it that scrappy, fun little I Spy look to it. But there's definitely at least one piece on each side, because all the panels, when they made the rows, all end up being about the same. Because you end up having to go 42 or 43 down the one side and the other side. And then once you add those to the 23, you're pretty much, you know, on the way, right? You're close. And it doesn't take very long to build it up. And it's nice to be able just to take from the pile and just mix and match and have some fun and, you know, pull different colors together. that, you know, you wouldn't think normally would go together, like this cream and green and red next to the gray snowflake. This is just stars. You know, it may not necessarily scream Christmas to you, but I like stars, and stars are beautiful at Christmas. They make beautiful ornaments on the Christmas tree. And of course, you could easily make this as a nice placemat. I thought, you know, when I had about six or seven of them together, I'm like, that would make a nice placemat. Or even a nice, lovely table runner with a little sashing or a little border on either side. Jeez. You know, use your Dresden ruler for more than just making some flowers, right? Or, you know, whatever you use your Dresden ruler for. Yeah, some beautiful fabrics here. I love the ones that say joy. Those I got from the big gifted box from Jo Marie. So thank you both to Lois and Jo Marie for the continuation of this project, this weekend project today. They were our fabric and tool sponsor, in a way. And just have fun. Have fun placing it. You can really mix and match your colors or have fun with your stash. Seeing these row against row against row, I think would be really nice. Maybe a little sashing in between. You don't have to. You could make some a nice little wall, or even, you know, quilt matching the wide ends together and then the narrow ends together. You could do that. That would be kind of a neat shape. Like, you know, do what inspires you. So, and we're very, very excited about Saturday's 12-hour. Very, very, very. Very, very. Haven't said very yet. Hopefully everybody else is too. We like hanging out with you guys and sharing what we're working on and having a good time. We want to be with you just as much as you want to be with us. So, and we appreciate your company. We appreciate the lovely community we have here that's very encouraging and loves to hang out and chat. Not necessarily always about sewing stuff. There's a whole other life that goes on besides sewing. There's gardens and kids and grandkids and husbands and wives and you name it. It's everybody's just sharing and enjoying their life. You know, it's the way it should be. And, you know, try not to think too hard about what goes what and what goes where. And if you feel that you have too much on the side of a color, then you can still work on that side. This doesn't have to be the end piece. It could be, you know, a centerpiece, right? So be flexible. Be creative. Be spontaneous. Things don't always go your way. Well, maybe it smells to meant to be something else. So I can see this being a lovely table runner, having these all together. And it doesn't necessarily have to be like Christmas fabrics, right? It could be anything. There. So I think I needed 22 or 23 to make up my row. So let's just plug away for a bit here and then we'll do a count. I think it should be pretty much everything on the table, but you know, sometimes my counting skills aren't so neat. Nope. Let's do this one. I like that one. I like the cardinals with the pine trees. That's such a beautiful green fabric. Sorry, Sass. It's green. All right, let's put one of these in. And hopefully this inspires you, if you have a Dresden ruler or if you've been wanting a Dresden ruler, to bust maybe some of your panels, and at least you get them bigger. And you don't, if you have a bigger panel, you don't have to do all the way around. You can just do like a side and a bottom or a side and a top. And it would still, and then just put a, like a border, a thicker border around the other side. It's not as thick as the border piece you're adding in the fabric creation. But you could go crazy. You could have all sorts of fun. It doesn't have to be, you know, all the way around. You can just do two sides or, you know, I'd say more of a top and a bottom and a top and or a bottom and a side than just doing like two tops and or two sides, but that's just me. Hey, you never know. It might look good.
You might like it.
And then you're going to want to make sure you give this a press before you do your cutting to try and get it down to the right size for your row. Try to speed up just a little bit here.
Okay, I like this green. Oops, make sure you go the right way.
Just lay them on top. It's super easy. It's almost kind of mindless because it's almost like you just know those two flat edges need to line up. And as long as the top is good, the bottom should be good. And away you go. So they say. Do 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 do. And of course, Wednesday is July 1st, which is Canada Day. Indeed, indeed. It'd be nice just to take a chillax day with Pop and Munchkin. Celebrate our 25th wedding anniversary. All right, so now when it comes to this part, you want to give it a press, okay? Oh, I think we're missing one. Here, let's add that. Let's add it because it probably needs to go on it. If not, oh well, oh, we'll just cut it off. Not a big deal. Okay, there we go. Sophie's moving around in her chair. And I finished off the wall hanging that we were working on last Saturday. Is that beautiful? Is that lovely? Now I'll just pop that there for a second while I iron this so you can take a look at it. It turned out really, really nice. I'd be excited to give it away tomorrow. So I just figured get it done because I wasn't sure how long I was going to take when it comes to the block of the month, because I'm always making some sort of mistake, but I'm going to try harder this time not to make any, considering I think we're more than halfway through on it, so let's just try not to make any. But life is life, and you just got to roll with the punches. I know my mistake, so I fixed it. All right, give that a nice pressing to make it nice and flat. And then you just want to make sure you're trimming it up to the size you need. Okay, let's pop this on my chair. Okay, let's move this out of the ways. Here. And of course, we need it to fit the top of this beautiful one right here. If I remember correctly. It was actually 42 and a half. Okay, so 42 and a half. And then you just want to lay your fabric out for one. See how this one's sticking out a little bit beyond here? Just try and lay it as flat as possible. Make sure I'm covering the zero line with my fabric as well as, oh, I put more than I needed. Okay, alrighty. Here, let's scoot this one then. I like the red on the outside. Eight and a half, 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 half. Okay, and try and get it on some sort of resemblance of a line. And hopefully it's looking pretty even, McStevens. And then you're just going to want to even up some of those that are looking a little long in the toothies, as they say. And same with the bottom half, because if you were to add a border or anything, you would want it to be straight. Just, there we go. Just hanging out just this minute. Okay, so now, oops, now we've got to trim, trim, trim. So 42 and a half, so I'm going to come in, go 42 and a half, go straight up. That can be saved for another panel. Save for something else. Come back over here to the zero. Again, pressing firmly, cutting. Of course, that can be used for something else too. Move that over there, so it's off the visual screenness here. And then we just take our panel here, lay it out, decide what we want to be forward in our little creation. Maybe there was too many colors of the same over in this area. We could do a little flip. You can flop. You can do whatever you like. I like it better the other way because then those two reds are together and we don't want that. Those are together. That's fine. All right. So just lay it out corner to corner, edge to edge, and then just pin it and sew it. And you have just busted a whole bunch of scraps as well as a panel you've had sitting in your stash for Coon's age. Coon's age is a long, long time. Just saying. Because raccoons live forever. Well, maybe not forever, ever. But okay, and then we're just going to sew that down. Adding it to the top. And like I said, it ends up being a 43 by 23 panel with using this layer cake Dresden ruler. Just bulks this out in no time flat. And you've really busted your scraps. You've made something pretty and unique. And you used your Dresden ruler for something else besides making flowers. You built a border. You built a fabric border out of your stash. I think that's a great, great win right there. Go and we'll press that, and that is another way, oops, to work with the panel. Right. Make sure we're good without any pins. Okay, let's do a little press. And that makes a lovely lap quilt, cuddle quilt for the couch, the cottage, the cabin, the trailer, what have you. And you're just using a really good centerpiece and then just bulking it out with the beauties of your fabric. So, and because there's lots of edges and raw edges all the way around, it's not just one raw edge, I will go all the way around with just a base stitch, which is would be like a 5.0 on my machine, and just go all the way, just to make sure things are going to stay nice and square if I just decide to put this right on the long arm and not put a border on it. Okay, there we go. Working with panels. Number 5. Hopefully this inspires you to make something different with your Dresden. Take care, everybody. Have a fantastic day, and we'll see you tomorrow on the 12-hour live stream, June 27th, 2020. Take care, everybody. Big hugs.